Feel the rhythm, feel the rhyme, get on up. It's MMO show time.
Snap.
That was good. This is episode 24, recorded on Friday, January 22nd, 2016.
Hey, folks, I'm Belgast of the Agri Chat podcast. What is our podcast, you ask? Well, the idea is really simple. Get a bunch of friends together, hit record, and see what happens. If that sounds interesting to you, you should totally check us out. We're a proud member of the Gaming and Entertainment Network at tgenetwork.net.
All right, party people!
We're playing as life allows and podcasting about it. It's the MMO show!
That's not good.
No.
We ready?
All right, ready?
You started!
Out there without care. Yeah, you're out of touch, but it's because I didn't know enough. I just knew too much. Does that make me crazy? Does that make Jason crazy?
A little bit.
Or is Shannon crazy?
A little bit.
Probably. And I hope you're...
That's a different part of the song. So we're ready to go?
Oh, we're going. We're going. Oh. Hey.
What up?
Oh, yeah.
Houston!
We are live!
The MMO show!
It is.
We're just about ready to go!
How does he do that?
We're gonna talk about some games! It rhymed, but I didn't say it anyway. Does that make us crazy? Does that make us crazy? Crazy, probably.
I'm intimidated being around all these wordsmiths.
Yeah,
I'm more like a wordsmith apprentice.
I'm sorry, cool running.
Because they're awesome.
The other day, so.
Oh well, yeah.
Welcome to the MMO show, episode 24. It's happening right now. Oh my gosh.
And you can't stop it.
They can stop it. They can just turn it off.
Don't tell them that.
Oh! On this episode tonight, we have your usual stars of the show. We've got Jason.
Hello.
And we've got Brent.
What up?
And we've got Steve.
Howdy.
And I'm Shannon. And this is a little segment we like to call, What Are You Drinking? We're going to start off with Brent because I see he's actually drinking at this moment. What you got there, pal?
I've got good old trusty Bud Light.
All right.
How many of those have you had tonight?
I've had three or so. We just got done with the other podcast, and so I had a few during that show.
I saw that tweet. I was like, oh, I should check that one out, too. I check it out on the YouTubes.
It's Australian.
Yeah.
Australians.
Are they up at, like, 4 a.m. their time or something?
It's like 10 a.m. their time,
okay,
which is still early for them.
It's not so bad, though. Slurms.
Just general for Australians.
What's your beverage?
Di Serono on the rocks.
Lovely. Go on classic. Mm-hmm. Look at you, you classy snot.
Mm-hmm.
Jason, what you got?
I got some hot tea.
I made him tea.
I'm getting over a cold.
They cinnamon sachet. Oh. Lovely. Yeah.
So. Is that a Coors shirt that I see you rocking?
It is.
Damn.
It's like Superman busting out of this.
Did you borrow that from someone we know, or was that just in your own wardrobe?
It's in my wardrobe. It's in the rotation.
Okay.
You know, work clothes and the such.
I don't know if a certain rapscallion from around the Detroit area.
No.
Oh, we can't keep up with that guy.
It's all mine, baby.
Yeah.
And so he might come steal it. I don't know.
Slurms is talking about last week we had our fantasy football awards ceremony, and the person we had do our interviews as people came in on the red
of ceremonies,
carpet.
I guess.
Yeah, he was a wild card, but it was an amazing night. So everyone got awards, and everyone was surprised, and everyone got too tipsy. I got too tipsy, but that's all right.
I was like, I don't think I did, but no. From your perspective, probably everybody else was drunk. Right?
Everybody's fine.
Everybody else needs to drink up. Yeah. I don't know what they're doing. They all seem too sober.
That actually was happening towards the end of the night.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Hence the, hey, let's go do shots.
Yeah. A lot of people said that.
People had fun.
All night. They did. I got people like messaging me the next day apologizing. Like, what for? And they're like,
It's a good night.
Yeah. And I'm like, why are you apologizing? Like, I had a little too much fun and I repeated myself a little too much.
I was
told
I was supposed to apologize.
Fine. Pretty much.
People were apologizing to you, or you were apologizing?
They were calling and apologizing to me. I'm like, well, I didn't think you were inappropriate, so I must have been inappropriate too.
I don't think anybody was inappropriate.
I thought it was, fun.
Except Johnny Hustle.
Johnny Hustle is always inappropriate.
He's a handful.
We did record it, and I'm hoping to get it edited together, put it up on YouTube. It'll be fun. Could be fun. Could be embarrassing. We'll see.
Wait to relive the memory.
Yeah. I have this evening a Merlot as big surprise.
That's right. No one asked you.
No
we're
one
jerks.
Ever asks me.
All three of us
are
jerks. So what are you drinking?
I have Merlot.
I think, should we make it a rule that the
it's
host
actually
always
really
starts
terrible.
With what they're drinking
terrible
and then passes
Merlot.
It on?
That's a good one. That way we don't look like jerks.
Yeah.
It's
really Shannon's fault making us look
making
like
us look like jerks.
Yeah. I'm sorry. Yeah, right. Really you're right. Bad
so
hosting.
How Merlot did you go?
This is pretty bad tonight. My friend gave me a good bottle of Merlot at the award ceremony, and I drank that already. So
that's okay. I'm texting my wife to see if she'll bring me another beer.
Yeah.
See if this works.
Could work. Jason and I text each other all the time in the house because it's just easier. But anyway, moving on. I guess.
Is that a potential business service that you're going to have?
Aww.
Bringmeabeer.com?
You know.
You got too many.
Genius.
Actually, speaking.
I started a new one.
Bring me a beer. You'll be driving everywhere.
It's a box in a box box.com.
I want coffee delivery in my office. Like, I don't want to have to drink the office coffee. I want.
Yeah, that stuff sucks.
I want Tim Hortons or Starbucks or, like, something. I would love it if the local independent coffee shop had delivery. But no one delivers coffee.
That's why Keurigs were invented. people start putting them in their homes after that.
Yeah.
Well, we always thought about, like, when we were younger, to have, like, the Sin Wagon where we'll deliver you, like, beer, condoms, and smokes, right? And you could, like, charge a premium for that because it's, like...
People are desperate. They're calling for that.
Yeah. Hey, I need a pack of condoms. Oh, you're going to pay for this. Just ask your girlfriend if it's worth it, you know.
There was services like that kind of started when all the boom happened, because I remember I've heard video game... I think Brad Shoemaker talked about... Was it the PS2 launch? Kind of there was a site where you could just order... whatever, and they'd run to the store and grab it, and he had put, like, a PS2, like, right when they came out, thinking there's no way that they would find one, and they did. They showed up at his door.
No crap.
Yeah.
Wow, I don't remember hearing that, but that's pretty rad.
Yeah.
Now, I remember, like, I've been at, like, golf outings before where there's been, like, someone that has the beer cart, and you call from wherever you are, and then they'll go to your hole and bring you beer.
Yeah, they will. That's why you golf. I mean,
I worked at a golf course for 5 years. I never drove the beer cart.
No,
I didn't like the guys get really flirty.
Yeah,
and I don't like that. I worked in the pro shop.
There you go.
Oh, well, yeah, knowledgeable. I mean, you play a lot of golf, right?
I never played golf once.
Did you did you compliment them on their grip?
No.
That's like when I worked in a Mac store when I was in undergrad, and I had never used a Mac. People did not like when I didn't have no answer to anything.
Yeah, no viruses.
Yeah.
It's all good. It's all
you never get a virus.
I've never had a virus on a Mac. I can tell you that, honestly.
And that'll be $3,000.
People buying Macs will pay it. It's fine.
Oh, yeah. No, the people who went in there knew.
They knew they wanted one.
Almost all of them knew the answer to all the questions. They just wanted to order one and get the student discount.
Mm.
Lovely. Well, We all went through some college jobs there. Jason and I did anyway. What'd you guys do in college? What was your crap job?
I was in a band.
Were you really? What did you play?
I played bass guitar.
I'm just kidding, because you were just playing the guitar, so I was
shredding.
Just joking.
I didn't play that guitar back then. I played
a different specific one.
It was
a newer guitar, right?
But I played bass, like the 4-string thing. Boom, boom, boom.
Cool. What'd you do, Steve?
I didn't have a college job.
Oh, yeah. What'd you do in your teen years, your early 20s?
Actually, my very first ever job, coincidentally
job.
To your story, I worked as a caddy.
Oh, we had carts.
Well, we had carts, too, but it was at a country club, so there was still...
People like bossing people around.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Here, use this 150-pound bag with a leather strap for the strap.
Strap it to the 118-pound boy.
Shoulder,
yeah.
Carry it for 4.5-5 hours. It wasn't too bad. Actually, from the whole ordeal, got my picture in the paper. Because we have an annual tournament here where I live called the Mad Anthony Tournament. And the one year that I actually worked at the country club where I worked, they were hosting it there rather than at the normal place. And like people from the paper, there was like a bunch of famous people there. I got to see Jim Davis and guy that drew Garfield, for those who don't know.
Everyone should know.
Yeah.
Dave Thomas, founder of Wendy's, was there. A bunch of other people.
Dang.
Was this before he died?
It was before he died. The tournaments after were way more fun, though.
Yeah, I would imagine.
This thing going on.
Fuck yeah.
But you didn't eat the hamburger.
the shitty story that I have, if we're talking about shitty job stories, was from that, because we had all these big name people and like all the other caddies that were there who had done events prior, because prior to that, there was another country club that would host it, and then the caddies from this country club where I worked would actually go over there and help out because they needed more caddies. But it was at our place this year, and everybody was like, oh, yeah, you get tipped, like, get massive tips during this event. I was like, oh, I was getting all excited.
To get lots of tips?
Just the tip. But the guy that I caddied for was no one famous. There was a guy in our group. He was a cheapskate. Yeah, you already figured it out.
Yep. Sorry. I've ruined your whole story.
You did. It's okay.
I'm sorry. That's my thing.
There was a guy.
So he didn't tip you much.
I get back and everybody's talking about like their $100 tips that they got. And this guy tipped me like $10.
Were you really psyched then when that movie Who's Your Caddy came out?
I was. I actually wanted to boycott it, but whatever. It wasn't realistic.
You were the one in the theater going, yeah, right.
They're straying from the art that is caddying.
That's not what it was really. That's not how it wasn't real.
The only the only really, really big of, well, they had a lot of events, but the only really big one was once a year they had a event that none of us were allowed to work because it was the local strip club would have their golf outing, and so all the ladies from the club worked the golf course. So like none of us could work because the guys would get confused about who they could tip for what. Yeah, because like they would get a topless caddy for the day.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah.
How many times you do that, Slurms? May I clean your balls?
Yeah.
You wash your balls.
They could only be topless like on the back nine. The front nine was like there's a big major road and they all had to put their shirts on for that part. Yeah. But
only the front two.
Classy place.
They only have the front two on the back nine.
Anyway, let's talk about what we're playing, I guess.
Are we sure we want to do that?
It's been a little weird this week, right?
Yeah.
Let's start with Jason. He's got because he's first on the list. So, Jason.
I'm always first.
Yeah.
Number one on the list. Number
with
two
in
your list.
Yeah. I've been still plugging away at Old Republic. And I think I am near the end of what is released of the new story content so far. They're going to be releasing updates. So, Actually, I was playing just before we started, and I'm right at the end or near the end, and I really, really like it. It's still something that I think is really well done. The storytelling continues to kind of surprise me with the route they're going, and kind of really, you know, embracing the idea that they don't have to stick to the structure that they had with the original story on all the, you know, campaigns. My thought is, once I finish this, I hope I have the drive to go see some of the other story stuff while I wait for the newer stuff to drop.
That was actually going to be my question, is like, when you're done with this, are you going to keep playing? Like, is with the new storyline, is it just the one storyline with various choices?
Yeah, so the new storyline, like, once I've seen that, it's, you know, it's cross class. It's not something that the way they reference your story, there's going to be some tweaks and changes, but the overall story is going to be the same. Okay. In this new stuff. There are choices, and I've already kind of seen them branch, but I the story's not wrapped up, so I don't know how it'll end, but I'm getting the feeling it's going to be like the Telltale or, you know, most of BioWare stuff, where you're going to come to the same conclusion with a couple of different wrinkles.
Gotcha.
And I'm not one who has a huge problem with that in games. It's just, you know, if it's well done, that's what I care about.
Is it mostly still the typical BioWare, like black and white choice, like good choice, bad choice?
No. So what I really like about this, and I won't get into a ton of spoilers, is how they're mixing up the Sith and the Republic to where you're fighting a common enemy, but there's not a clear good or bad way to go about it.
Gotcha.
And I think I played my consular very light side, and there was a really great moment where I had to make a choice where I really kind of had to stop and think, and I took about 10 minutes of I got up and kind of walked around and then made my choice, and it was the first dark side choice I think that guy's made in the whole game, but I just couldn't see a way around it. And I kind of put myself in his mindset. He was being selfish at that moment because, you know, I think that the guy that I was playing, that's what he would have done, or, you know, how I had kind of set him up. That was awesome. And to see how it kind of played out was fun. So, I'm definitely going to stay. I think they're releasing the next story thing in February. I haven't looked a ton into it, but I see myself, like, I've only finished, I think, two stories in that game, like class stories. I want to go see some other ones. So I think I'll do that while I kind of wait for the rest of, or the next chapter of the story, the expansion. So
and are you basically max level? I mean, is that where you are story-wise?
Okay. Yeah, I've been max level for a while. It's just kind of I'm going through the story for the first time.
Okay.
You get legacy levels, but, you know, you're at max level and you have your abilities.
JBJ Blaze wants to know, is there any first person mode in SWTOR, and what's the combat system?
You can go into first
person. Is there? I wasn't sure if you could. I never tried that option.
Yeah,
so,
okay. Yeah, it's been there. I knew a guy who had played that way, actually, just to try to for immersion. But it's like WoW. It's kind of the cooldown.
You got hot bars.
Tab targeting.
You have tons of abilities in that game.
And you need them. So it's hot bars,
you know,
everywhere.
A good three quarters of them. I have some to the side that are relegated to, you know, that I hardly ever use. I don't know, but I like the combat in that game. I think it's decent. It's not action oriented. It's tab targeting, cooldown.
It's not like a Neverwinter or a Guild Wars.
No. And they haven't really, speaking of combat, they haven't changed a ton about combat, but I will say the one thing that's kind of had me, down about the brand new content is it's super easy. With the Revan and the Hutt stuff, I remember kind of some fights where I had to think a little bit more and use more strategy, not so much in this. You can definitely tell that they want people to see the story in this.
Yeah. There was actually
not get too caught up in the boss fights.
I was just gonna say, speaking of the ease of it, there was somebody on Reddit the other day. I was on the SWTOR subreddit, and someone had posed a question if the game, like, later had any, like, difficult dungeons and stuff, and most of the consensus on the subreddit, at least, was that the game's actually pretty much a cakewalk. There's some group content that you can do, but even then, compared to a lot of other MMOs, it's not difficult stuff, so it's more about experiencing the world than it is anything else.
Yeah.
Yeah, I always really had a great time in Flashpoints, though, because the storytelling in them was so well done, and I really like the system they have for making decisions, how you roll.
Yeah.
For who gets to make the choice, and that was kind of like, you know, D&D-ish. Not really, you don't roll to make a choice in D&D, but, you know, it was like that element of chance.
Jason really liked seeing my choice the other day with my smuggler. So.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so we played Tuesday, and I think it was... I think it was Brent's idea to play Tuesday, but he didn't show up. So we played.
What was up with that, Brent?
I don't even know why. I remember Wednesday going, "Are we playing tonight?" And going, "Oh, that was yesterday."
Last night.
And going, "Oh," and I was about to say something to Slack, and I was like, "I don't care why I didn't show up." I didn't even say anything. I was just like, "I figure they, you know." And I saw that y'all had talked about playing, but I didn't know if y'all did. So I'm glad y'all did. I wish I had, though. I kind of started playing some SWTOR.
Yeah, so we tried to do some Flashpoints, just the two of us, because they made them to where you could solo them. And I kind of assumed they would make it then where it would scale from, like, two or three players.
There were assumptions made.
Yeah, which is my fault. Yeah, it's not. It's either you can solo it, and then it scales to you, or you have to do it as a group. So... if we were to do it again, you know, if we didn't have a full group, we could just use a group finder.
I wasn't there. I didn't play.
No,
and I will not be playing.
Just Slurms and I. So
no. Didn't go well.
At that point, but we figured it out. Yeah, we tried to go through, and then we realized through error of trying to go through it that it was not like made for two people.
The third or fourth trash mob in was, like, just decimating our companions. And hey, these guys are really fucking us up.
Yeah. So if we do it again, we'd have to probably use group finder. But I don't know, I'm going to stick with it. I'm definitely going to keep playing until the next chapter stuff comes out, which is next month. And hopefully see some of the other story stuff. Like I said before, with the class experience bonus, you can kind of just mainline story and see that. And I haven't seen most of it, and I want to, so...
Is it 50 levels or 60?
65 it went up to.
What?
Okay. You are so far behind.
Right? I'm only 32, I think.
I tried. I had uninstalled the game a while back, and I had removed all the files everywhere. And I remember they had told me, like, that the bug I had, like, it didn't matter if you uninstall. Once you get that bug, like, you just have it. But I tried anyway to reinstall it because there was a new patcher and everything. And nope, can't install the game. I get the launcher, and it stays at 0% forever. It's a bitrater bug. That's a known random bug. And I could call and support, and they will walk me through how to finagle all that again. But it's like, at this point, but I could just go play another game.
But a new computer would fix it, right?
I don't know. Probably. But I'm okay with mine. So can I move on to me?
Mm-hmm.
All right. So instead of doing that, I played Neverwinter, and I'm still playing that. And I got a couple extra people playing Neverwinter lately, so that's cool. I met up with my D&D buddy, and we did a couple of quests together, little mini dungeons, last night. And yeah, having a good time. But then a couple people today said that they were gonna download it again. I think Slurms was one of them.
I did.
You seemed bitter, though, about it. Like, you were like, I downloaded it.
Fine.
It's taking up space on my hard drive.
Yeah,
that's okay. I got it installed. Mm-hmm. I was not super excited about it because last night, and actually, I think the night before, too, I've kind of just been, like, sitting and staring at my computer not knowing what to play.
Mm-hmm.
Like, SWTOR is cool, but, like, it's not really grabbing me.
Seems like a lot of people have that problem lately, because in our little group chat that we have, All of us are kind of talking right now about, you know, what can we play? We all want to play something together. We miss the old days of playing stuff together. I've been uploading a lot of our old episodes of our old shows to our old YouTube channel, so nostalgia is really thick right now. And we miss those times of just like, okay, pick an MMO, and we're just all going to be there and go all in and have that good time. But picking the MMO is a problem.
Yeah, so I've been staring, and then you keep mentioning Neverwinter, and it wasn't something that was exciting me to go back to, but then on our chat today, somebody had mentioned some of the new classes and stuff that had come out since I had been playing, and one of them was a Warlock, and typically when I hear Warlock, I think caster is not really my cup of tea, but I started reading into it some more, and it seemed more and more like my cup of tea. So then I got excited. So I do have the game installed now, and I have my character made, and I'm in the starter zone starting all over. So
I have a Warlock. She's awesome.
Is she? Okay.
Yeah, it's really, really, really overpowered.
Is it?
At least.
Except the last class that was added, right?
Paladins and Warlocks.
Oh, Paladins.
Were the last two added. Ranger was the one before that.
Right. Ranger, I think, was the first.
Yeah, the first added. New one. Yeah.
That's crazy. They've been supporting the crap out of that.
They launched two big modules in 2015, and they totally redid all their dungeons in that they, like, you can now group together. Back when we played before, you couldn't group together. I think I mentioned this on the podcast before. Now they have three what they call leveling dungeons. You only need three people to do them. They can be of any, they're designed so that you can be any class combo and get through them, and you can be any mix of levels, like 19 to 70 for the first one, for the first bracket. And
so
then
I need to
Kragmar.
Get to 19.
Well, to start doing that stuff. But we can, but before you can start comboing like groups with level 70s, and low levels together. Until then, we could still run stuff at comparable levels together, you know?
Well, can we do the stronghold stuff? Because that doesn't that raise you up to 70?
It raises you up to 70, and you need about it's like five people content. But yeah, we can just go over to the stronghold and do stuff.
So there's options now.
Oh yeah, yeah, definitely, lots of more.
I can't remember the player
grade
stuff.
Before.
Was that like there was that a minimum of, to that?
We had to be within a certain level range of each other. Otherwise, the highest level person would decimate the experience for the other person.
Yeah, that's what happened when we tried.
And it was very frustrating for people. And playing together was hard that way.
Gotcha.
But once we all hit 70, you know, no problems. Yeah. We can just do everything together. Anyway, so yes, I've been uploading all of our old multiplaying CODcast and all the CODcast and Ravencast are uploaded, and I'm working on the multiplaying episodes, getting those on. What?
Did I just hear cock-ass ramming?
Yeah, cock-cast and ramming.
Oh, cock, okay.
Cast episodes. Sorry, I talk really fast sometimes.
I thought I missed something like really bizarre. So,
cock-piece ramming.
No, I talk fast sometimes and stuff slurs all together. I'm sorry. And Clash of Clans, I'm actually working on right now, staying logged in, because I keep getting almost the amount of coins I need to get my crossbow. But as soon as I log off, before I can get the actual amount I need, and I'll log off, and then I get attacked, and then they take all my money, and I can't get my crossbow. So I'm staying logged in this time until I get my crossbow tonight. That's my goal this evening. And
on
I've been playing
game?
Minecraft. Clash of Clans.
Clash of Clans. Sorry about that.
Oh. That's all right. I'm talking really quick because I want to get through a little bit more here. Brent.
Sure.
What's up?
I heard you've been... Well, one, happy birthday. Sunday was your birthday.
Thanks.
Did you have a good time?
Yeah, it was just a family affair, nothing big. So, yeah, fun stuff. But I did play a little bit of, I hopped in that one night in Neverwinter and looked at the Stronghold stuff. It looks like it could be fun, like with a group, and I kind of like that building of an area, and it's really big. Like, it's much bigger than I thought it was. It's like a continent to itself, like in another game. So I'd really like to get into that and see that. But I've also been playing a little bit of SWTOR, got a couple levels in there, and it's been enjoyable. It's almost like a single player game at the moment, you know, because you're just going through the storyline.
Yeah.
But it's good, and I have enjoyed it, and I haven't been bored when I play. It's actually been like, oh, I need to log off and go to bed kind of thing. Now I did hop into Elite Dangerous again, and I have some other friends who played, and they kind of walked me through some of the stuff.
And so
now I've, you know, I've gone into spaceships or whatever they're called and landed and taken off and killed some crap and asteroids. One of my birthday presents, I got a Thrustmaster.
I was going to ask if, like, you were using, like, one of those special flight sticks and stuff, because don't you have to play that game? Or
no, you don't have to. But
it seems like everyone I know on Twitter that is playing that game has one, though.
I tend to roll. Yeah, with the mouse trying to, like, keep steady, it was kind of...
Impossible.
So anyway, I got this, and I haven't even plugged it in yet, because it's like, I know that's going to be an hour of, like, setting up buttons, I think.
I will say, I have the same stick, and it takes, like, no time whatsoever. Most of it's already default.
You're just ready?
Yeah.
Ready to go.
Plug the thing in, and you're good, man.
So, and it doesn't work well?
Yeah, I've played a little bit of Elite Dangerous, and I haven't played enough to really be proficient to talk about it.
Yeah.
But as far as the actual feel of the control, you have to get used to what's doing what, because, I mean... I mean, if you're not used to using it, you're learning. So, but no, once you get used to what's what, it's relatively easy to fly around. I have more of a problem with the game is just knowing like what I'm supposed to be doing. It's so open of a game. I'm not used to that.
Right.
And I'm not used to playing in Space Sims anyway. So, it's very, I don't know. It seems like there's a ceiling there that I'm not able to reach to yet. I have to learn quite a bit.
Well, and that's kind of the one thing that worries me is so playing that one night and everybody telling me like, oh, well, you can do this and this and this and this.
Right.
It really just sounded like Eve, and it really played like Eve to an extent. I mean, the combat's definitely much different. But it's like, you know, you can go mining or you can go, you know, deliver the goods from this station to the other station.
Mm-hmm.
And so I wonder,
guess the only thing I've done successfully is to deliver something to another station. When I had to go, I had another mission pop up where it said I had to go find this person and take him out. And then I went and I could not find where the person was. So
like a bounty?
I think that might have been what it was.
I'm making up words because I'm not really sure yet.
So that all sounds correct.
Are they planning to add in like a bunch more like stuff like with the planet stuff and stuff
yeah.
differentiates it from like Eve and
yeah, they're,
I know
they're...
people are gonna kill me for saying that it's like Eve in the first place.
I think the thing people have been really comparing it to is Star Citizen, right?
Yeah,
more so than Eve.
Except there's nothing to do in Star Citizen.
Yeah,
you can't
I mean,
say that. People are going to kill you.
Well, not yet. Eve's you know, released Star Citizen's in alpha. But they're going to be Elite. They're in the first part of their second season of content, and the rest of this season, which is spread out, I think, over this year, is going to include more ground stuff and getting out of your ship, I believe.
Okay.
I think part of me wants to almost wait for that stuff because right now I feel like I am just the ship.
Yeah, you are.
Oh, I don't like being a ship.
Yeah, and I just...
You can right now buy additions to put like a rover on your ship and do that and kind of mine, but that's about it right now.
Yeah. I feel so lonely. I feel like this lonely machine
Space is lonely.
Space should be lonely, yeah.
Well, we should all hop into... And play together and you know, I don't know if y'all know the other guys that play with like Bitburner and Afro Monkey and RP Gamer, but
you guys have like, a whole group.
There's like five of them that play, so the three of us, four of us, if Shannon jumps in.
Oh no.
All of a sudden we've got like a big group playing the same game kind of thing. So I don't know, just an idea. But I'm kind of in the same, I guess, thought as you, Slurms, is right now I'm. Really want to do is get good with the controls and make a little bit of cash to get ready for what I think hopefully the game will be eventually.
And the game honestly doesn't take long to grasp the basic mechanics to feel like you know what you're doing.
Well, and you can tell me if there's something further than this, but kind of the aha moment or the point where I said, okay, now this I like is once I got into basically light speed and you're just flying around planets and suns like super fast. And it's like, you know, timing your jump or I forget what it's called, but when you go in and out of that, hitting the J button.
Yeah, the jump drive into, jump drive. I think it's Super Cruise.
Yeah, Super Cruise. Like, Super Cruise is a lot of fun in itself. Just like, because, like, when I first started, you know, it's like you see that planet and it's just like you're puttering by and you're like, ah, this doesn't sit. But you get jump speed and that planet zooms by you and you're just swinging around it to get somewhere else. It was,
that's
fun.
That's the big, I think, like you said, aha moment of that game is when I figured out how to nail down charging up, plotting my course, and coming out of light speed and monitoring kind of your distance and speed traveling to make a good jump to where or a good exit so that you're right where you're supposed to be. That's like, I think, the really satisfying part of that game.
You ever fly by a planet and like stick your ass cheeks up against the window of your ship so you can give them another moon?
No, I haven't done that. But one time I did, I flew by like way too fast and way too close. And this guy was drinking coffee and he spilled it.
Yeah. Did he yell Maverick?
I don't know. I was going too fast. I don't know if you know how sound is.
Did you get yelled at later?
Oh, I got my chops busted.
He said, I want some butts.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I had to go to the school though.
Yeah.
Yeah, and they made a whole movie about it.
That's awesome.
Hey, Jason, how's your best friend? He's still dead?
Too soon.
Spoiler alert.
You gotta go talk to Meg Ryan.
Oh, she's such a bitch. Okay. I have one more question for Brent before we move on. Are we done with Elite Dangerous?
Highway to the... one last thing. Paladins is really...
That's what I was going to ask you. Why is Paladins making you mad? Okay, wait. Paladins is by Hi-Rez Studios, and it's... I mean, not to... I'm sure that people don't like this when people do this, but it's their answer to TF2, right? Is that what this kind of...
Yeah, I mean, it's kind of coming out in the same vein as, like, Overwatch. TF2, it's a little different, like, almost I think it would be more fun if it was more like TF2, but it's kind of like this quick-based siege capture point thing, fast-paced, you know, shooter, but with random classes. I mean, they're not so much random because they are kind of building lore into the world around these classes, but let's be real, they're random classes. But the problem is no one knows how to play the damn game yet. And so it's just frustrating. Like, you get in every match and you're like, you've got to get on the capture point. Please, for the love of God, get on the capture point. And after you lose a couple matches a night to just people not knowing the game basics.
Yeah.
Not even, like, playing bad. It's a new game. Of course, people are going to play like shit. But it's just that. Like, I almost feel like they need, like, some quick rules to tell people. But I mean, I even had
this the objective.
Yeah. Like, but you would think if it's called like, Capture the Point is the name of the mode you're playing.
You would attempt to capture the point.
People might want to look for a point to capture is like, what you're saying.
And it's like, think to yourself, okay, if there's a point and you got to capture it, how do I capture it? Well, it's not go to their base. It's not shoot people away from the capture point. People got to get on it.
You think they should.
So you're more mad at the community that's in the beta testing rather than the actual game? Or do you
the game's fine.
Okay.
If play it correctly and not piss me off.
Gotcha. Do you think that there are in-game cues they should work on? Or is it just people just being goofy in beta?
Well, I was talking about this with some friends, and they made the good point that they're still changing stuff. So if they kind of put the rules front and center to people, that they may get those as like, those are the rules, you know, 3 months road, they change all those and people are then playing it wrong still, because once you read something once, you don't read it again sometimes.
And they gave, honestly, The game seems like it. I mean, it seems it's in beta, but it seems early beta. Like, it seems like there's a lot they still need to add to that game. I hope.
Yeah. Oh, I talked to Drybear, who's kind of running the show for it, which is crazy to me in itself. I mean, he came from like streaming games to Smite, and then all of a sudden he's like running a division on a new game. But he was saying that, you know, they're still trying to lock down the core mechanics. Like, they're still trying to get that, like, what's fun, how to do it, and with the cards and like all that. So
that's the impression I got playing that game. And I think it's got great potential, but it seems like, yeah, they're a ways off.
Yeah, it's just super early. And I mean, I'm glad people are playing it, even though, because I mean, you can't really test a game if people aren't playing it.
No, it's hard.
But you'd think someone would learn how to play it if they were playing it.
I want to apologize, Brent, for
say yelling at you, man. I hope that wasn't you.
He's like, oh God, that's Brent. That's why he thought you didn't show up for Star Wars: The Old Republic night.
Oh, you're joking, aren't you?
Let him wonder.
No, because I'm never like mean to people. But I do like I'll be like y'all do know you're supposed to give them a point, like more than just one person. So like I start tanking every game because I'm like at least I will get on the point. But yeah. So yeah, I'm sorry. Learn how to play the fucking game.
I'll try. I'll try to do it when you're.
You know
not
what,
playing.
Jason? It sounds to me like you should apologize to him.
I want to apologize officially. I will learn how to play the game, but I only when you're not playing, because I don't want to try to learn playing around you.
It's okay. I forgive you.
Thank you.
Let's see. Steve? Yeah,
that was tense. Hey.
We kind of covered everything you've been playing, but do you have anything to add to the mix?
Not in the MMO realm, really.
Gotcha. Do you want to hold on to it for cheating?
I don't know if I've even really been cheating on anything either.
All right. Well, we've got a TV we're going to talk about later with you. Some hardware. I have... Let's do news first, because I don't know if this topic's going to fly. It was a weird question I thought of today, being all nostalgic and wishy-washy. But I did want to talk about Heroes Song. Have you guys heard about this?
Yep.
I have not.
Okay. Mm-mm. Heroes Song is a game that is... Actually, could one of you that's heard about it talk about it real quick, so I can pull it up on the screen?
I know a little bit about it. It is a new MMO from John Smedley, and it looks like like isometric kind of view. I guess it would be fair to say it looks somewhat like Ultima Online. I don't know much more about that. No, absolutely no microtransactions. I know that. They made a big deal about that. Mm-hmm. And it was a lot, the Kickstarter to me was a lot of the talk that you hear from a lot of games, like, oh, you're going to be able to become a god in the game and things that I'm like, okay.
You said it was a roguelike game. Like, yes. Once you die, you're dead. You have to start over. Kind of like, you know, Don't Starve, right? Is the only thing I have to compare it to.
I mean, Don't Starve is a roguelike. So I didn't really understand how the MMO part came into it, or if everyone's just assuming it's an MMO because of John Smedley.
So players will be able to control their own server and host thousands of other players.
So, yeah, it has the potential to be an MMO because depends on the server hosting that you partake in. Yeah.
With up to hundreds playing at one time.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I don't know. Some people are really excited about this. Some people aren't. I am in the wait and see category just simply because I'm not a big fan of isometric games. And I'm not a fan of like the roguelike games like that. And I'm not a real big fan of games that are hosted by individuals.
Yeah.
Typically. I really like to have official servers for things because for me, I like to get out there and get to know people in the community. I'd like to play with a regular group of friends, but what always happens with us being, you know, tending to be like older gamers, especially casual gamers, as soon as, you know, a handful of people lose interest, you're all alone. you know, that happened with us when we tried to host our own Minecraft server, and our own Starbound server, and our own,
yeah.
Like, whenever we have these games where we have to host our own servers, that's what happens. It's like, nobody's there anymore, and it's like, ugh. Whereas, if you have a game that's hosted officially, you have the potential to at least go out and make a couple of new friends, join a new guild, get to know some people in the community again if you want to stick it out in that game. But yeah, that's my only problem with that.
I'm definitely waiting and see. The art style does not appeal to me.
Why do you think that is? Because you like Starbound was such a huge success and it had a very pixely look.
I don't know.
You know, and it was adorable and people really grabbed onto it and loved it.
I think that looked better in motion. Maybe it was because it was a 2D game, and this is
2D.
It's still 2D, but you're moving up and down, and you know, it's more over the top. Starbound was a side scroller.
Yeah.
It doesn't translate well to it, and you know, it's comparing itself now, kind of looking at to more like Diablo or Path of Exile. Like, I like those games. I like action RPGs, over the top kind of view. I don't like the look of this one, so I definitely won't be backing it. But if it's, you know, I'll definitely wait and see if people like it.
Yeah, I do like the writer they have working on the lore a lot.
Oh, I love that.
Name of the Wind is a fantastic
book. I definitely perked up because I am almost done with that book.
Yeah,
well, that book's amazing.
It's so amazing. But yeah.
The only thing I like about it is Smedley. Like,
yeah.
I don't like those type of games. Like,
I'm not a fan of those.
Diablo,
either.
I hate it.
Yeah, I'm not.
The graphics, like you said, I can't stand this. Like, I played Terraria. I didn't play Starbound because I hated the graphics was like a big thing in those to me that I was just.
It was a turnoff for you, yeah.
I played like once or twice and was like, yeah. I'm done. I think I feel like I was done with this when I had an Apple IIe. Like,
yeah.
It's just surprising when you have was it Albion Online?
Albion Online,
which is kind of a similar top-down look.
I like the look of that
game.
And
it's an MMO as well. Now, is that hosted servers as well?
I don't believe so.
So that's official servers.
I think that's straight up like MMO server type things. I could be wrong.
But maybe the gameplay is totally different.
Yeah.
To me, that's,
you know, the one thing, looking at it, like, it's not that far away.
What?
This game, Hero Song.
Oh, yeah.
Like, they're.
They have a lot done.
They're estimating delivery of, you know, like August, it looks like, for, I think, the full or beta one access.
Yeah, October for full launch.
Yeah, which, I mean, that's really short in terms of game development. But, I mean, hopefully that's not because it's fairly basic.
It's like there's stretch goals, advanced housing system. Like, do I really want a housing system in this?
Yeah.
Like, yeah, for people that like that sort of thing, and you
people
will.
Like housing, yeah.
But just.
But I know what you mean.
Like the, I don't know. Like, I don't want to. Like, to me, the thing that makes me sad about this is it's like. Okay, I do like Smedley. I mean, he was part of EverQuest when it first started. So I have fond memories of him and Brad McQuaid before, you know, Brad took the Coke train. But it's like
choo choo.
it's like now he's going to be devoting his life to this game, and that kind of makes me sad. Like, I almost wish he would
like wasted.
Do another MMO like Vanguard. Like Vanguard to me. Wait, Or was that Brad?
That was Brad that did.
See, now I get them all mixed up, like Smedley or Brad. But I guess since he had to leave Daybreak Games because of all that stuff with the hackers and whatnot.
Actually,
he went.
Apparently this has been DDoS attacked pretty harsh since the Kickstarter was announced.
I can't catch a break.
I know.
It's not. I mean, it looks like it might hit its funding goal.
It looks like it.
Yeah,
you know.
It's not. I don't. I kind of, with John Smedley's name, I kind of expected it to rocket a little bit more.
Expected a bigger push at the beginning.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like, you'll get that. They always get that big push at the end. I'm sure it'll make it. It's at 98,000. It's at almost 99,000 right now. and it needs 800,000, and it's got 26 days to go, so it's not that old. But I kind of expected it to be at least, you know, a couple hundred thousand by now.
But like, as we were all saying, all of us play MMOs, and we're, and Smedley is known in the MMO realm, and none of us are really that excited about it. I mean, I'm not saying like when it comes out, like it might. Actually,
no, if people
it,
love
I might
it,
come
definitely
check
look
it
into
out.
It.
Like, if, pretty much, I'll check it out if all of you guys check it out and tell me to. But it's not a game I would buy on my own. But at the same time,
I mean, it's pretty cheap. I mean,
at the same
bucks.
Time, I do hope they make it because I like the people involved. But
right.
I hope it's a success.
Well, I mean, that's the thing. It's like it comes out and I hope it does great. And someone says, hey, you got to buy this and then I'll try it.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know. It's like the first thing I saw when I saw that picture, like, I think I've actually gone here and looked at this because of some, maybe a tweet he did or whatever, just saw the picture and left. Like, my first impression of this is I would never play this.
Okay, JBJ Blaze brings up a good point. He says, but you got into Minecraft. What about its graphics? Now, Minecraft is something that has, very, very basic graphics. And it does still, you still have to have the hosted servers. So you're in these tiny little communities. And I have had to actively go out and find a community, one after another. Like, I just, relentless till I found one that I really enjoyed.
And I wonder if JBJ remembers what I said initially about Minecraft. Well, it was people like, man, you got to play this game. It's a great game. And I said, this looks like the worst game in the entire world. And it took me a bit to actually even try it. And as soon as I tried it, I got hooked.
So you liked it in spite of that, though?
Yeah, in spite
after
of
a while, you see the beauty in it, though.
Yeah.
Like, there's so many
times. The game has to be good.
Yeah, there's so much charm to it that eventually, like, sometimes you'll just be walking along and, like, it's all squares and pixely, but it they have moments in that game where it's really beautiful. So
I feel Minecraft was kind of different. Like, that kind of game really wasn't, or at least I hadn't played that type of game, like, just the game itself.
Yeah.
Whereas when I look at this, I feel like I've played this. With better graphics already. So it's like if Sky Saga had come out and I'd played Sky Saga for a while and then Minecraft came out, like, I don't know if it would have the same charm and appeal to me.
Gotcha.
If that makes sense.
Yeah. When Jason first told me about Minecraft, I'm like, I never really got into Legos. Like, I'm fine. It's cool.
Did you end up liking it?
And then, like, I think I was, you were home babysitting. It was a day we had to split up for D&D. And so I was at D&D and you called me during D&D and you're like, I'm buying this for you. I'm like, I don't care. And you're like, well, the name, all your names are taken. I can't get Zellybelly. And I'm like, I don't care. So he ended up making up using one of my old, really old, like, Warhammer character names and got it all listed and everything. And I get home and I'm like, I logged in once and I was like, cause he was so excited for me. I'm like, okay. And I died. Okay. Thank you. And then I didn't think I'd ever log in again, but I did. And then now I'm still playing and no one else plays it that I know, but I made new friends that play Minecraft. So it's okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Anyway,
well, it looks like a lot of people will be making new friends to play Heroes Song.
Yeah, because it's definitely it's definitely not something I think that's going to take off with me or the people I know that play MMOs, but it definitely might be a little niche thing for groups, new gaming groups to enjoy, maybe. Anyway,
now I'm backing it.
I'm rambling.
I gotta get this.
Help me, no. Somebody. So we did have a launch of an MMO this week. I don't know if y'all heard about Blade and Soul.
I heard about it. Haven't played it.
Jason's played it. Jason, you want to tell us about some Blade and Soul?
I've played. I am still like level 5.
Okay. What I understand, it is a martial arts style of combat where you perform combos and in order to make your attacks, but it's set up in a world of MMO questing, right?
Yeah.
And It's actually been out since 2012 in South Korea, and it's launched in some other countries, you know, after that, and it's finally come to North America and Europe. So, but it is a beautiful game. I will say, you know,
seems pretty.
Yeah, and in, you know, the tradition of Asian imports, the boob jiggly effect is insane. I made a character yesterday. I couldn't get on a server. I haven't been able to actually get on a server because the queues have been really crazy. But I did make a character, and oh my gosh, the boobies. The boobies are just all over the place. But yeah. It's like that's the physics. They it's like, and they didn't get it right. I mean, they're just all over the place. But okay, but that's cool. You know, that tends to happen. Happened in ArcheAge quite a bit. It happens in Terra. You know, that just happens. Boobs jiggle all over the place in Asian imports. So that's how it goes. Other than that, that's all I know. The character creation was pretty cool. And that's all I got to experience. Jason, you got to play a little bit more. You actually got to log in.
Yeah. And the writing is pretty garbage.
I didn't know. I had no idea. I actually was wondering which way it was going to go with that statement.
Yeah.
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 I mean, you guys kind of thought, figured it would be right.
I no idea.
I didn't know how the, you know, westernization went. Okay. I know that people who played this game were really complaining about how it was westernized because they said the characters became very cardboard, you know.
There's grammar errors that I've noticed.
Well,
it seems poorly translated. But the combat seems like it could be cool. It reminds me of Guild Wars 2. But also, this game could be like Terra, kind of. I get that kind of impression, too, especially with the art style.
Yeah.
There's been some people, like Belgast and some other people, who kind of have posted that they are pleasantly surprised. I don't know, you know, if they're going to keep playing. I'm going to leave it on my computer for a little bit longer. It's free. So I'm going to try to get to like level 10 or so and then kind of see.
I've seen a few comments as to, hey, this will keep my attention for a couple weeks, but then it's going to get deleted off my computer sort of thing. So
that's kind of the impression I'm getting right now.
Yeah, for yourself.
Yeah. Yeah.
I want to log in once just to see it, and then I'll be done with it. I think I will. Not really.
It's going to be your next MMO. You're going to love it.
Yeah. That probably will.
Hey, guys.
You're
going to
be all in.
These jiggly boobs. That's where it's at.
Tuesday night, we're going to jiggle some boobs together.
I did character creation, and just because I was like, okay, I'm curious. And they have this one like bikini outfit where like the bikini's triangles just cover up like the nipples, and you can adjust the breast size, of course. And so of course I went all the way big, and oh my god, it was ridiculous.
Is there any way to make them big enough? I mean, is there like a slider for the actual nipple size so that it's
no, not
the
nipple
size.
Si- no. But then you can make her like turn, and so they're just
anything bigger than a handful, and you're risking a sprung tongue.
They were everywhere. But no, my character has normal proportionate size stuff.
With the big fucking tits.
No. So, that's Blade and Soul.
Johnny Hustle's MMO of 2016.
Yeah.
Yeah, that guy.
That guy, right?
What a scamp.
Ooh. Do you have anything else going on with any MMO stuffs? Ready to move on to some cheating. There was a certain movie trailer that came out this week called Suicide Squad, and I'm gonna play it while we talk about it. But yeah, I can't use the sound because the song that's in it is obviously copyrighted.
It's a pretty famous song.
Check it out yourself. But let me get it started, and then we can kind of talk about it.
Started.
And I think that'll work. Okay. There we go. So, Suicide Squad trailer came out this week. Did everyone get a chance to see it?
I think.
You think you might have seen it?
I saw something where it was like Suicide Squad and like Marvel, another universe.
DC, but.
DC universe. But this is separate?
Yeah. This oh, okay. is.
I saw the one where they were going to mix the two up.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Mm.
And like a TV show that they were going to.
Oh, the. I don't know. I'm not sure what the hell you're talking about.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
It's like the Justice League and the Suicide Heroes, like all together or something.
The Legends of Tomorrow?
Sure. That... Sounds good.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm trying to decipher your logic, and I
that,
think that's...
No, that's all DC as well. Yeah. But yeah. And I do, just to kind of, we're off topic, but it's all DC, so it's okay. But we just watched that tonight. It actually was on last night.
Legends of Tomorrow.
Legends of Tomorrow, yeah. And it seems
like it could be fun.
I really like that DC's using TV to explore some of their less popular characters, because aside from the Holy Trinity, they're
able to get a movie out of.
Yeah, aside from Wonder Woman, Superman, and Batman, I mean, people don't really, you know, have a lot of DC characters. I mean, the diehard comic fans do, but in terms of general population, everyone knows Marvel characters.
There's a pretty big drop off after the Holy Trinity.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, a few of us old people remember. Yeah, a few of us old people remember, you know, the Super Friends, but we're getting pretty old. Like, young kids don't remember that.
Meanwhile,
Tsunami. What was his name?
Wonder Twin Powers, man.
The guy who just flew around is like a tornado. Was his name like Tsunami Nami or something? I don't know.
I don't know that guy. There's so many.
You know what I'm talking about, Dutch.
Jesus.
No.
What about the Wonder Twins?
The Wonder Twins.
Why isn't there a movie with the Wonder Twins yet?
We need to start a comic book podcast with Brent and just hit the half the episodes. And there's that one guy.
Around, man.
It would just be the whole.
We could do a call-in segment where someone has to not stump them, like try to get him a character.
And if
don't stump Brent.
If Brent can get it right, they win a prize.
Like, all right, Brent, you know this.
His name is Joker.
Yeah, you can't use everything else though besides their name.
That's breaking rules.
Joke.
But anyway, Suicide Squad is, if you're not familiar with the backstory, I'm going to butcher this because I am not big on
Brenton do it.
No. I think I could do a little bit better than But what Suicide Squad is, it is a bunch of, like, the worst of the worst criminals. Like, the Joker's in it, like, in it. So.
Well, technically, Joker's not in Suicide Squad.
Oh, he's not?
No.
I am so dumb. I'm sorry.
But he's not part of the Suicide Squad.
Well, I don't know. Who's in Suicide Squad? I know Harley Quinn is, so I just assumed Joker was.
Deadshot, Killer Croc.
Okay.
Boomerang. Enchantress.
Okay, well, it's the Katana. Worst.
Yes.
It's the worst of the worst criminals, except for Joker. And the government pretty much puts them all in this squad, hence the name. And if they don't do what the government tells them, they put a little bomb inside them and they'll blow their brains up. So
that's typically how it is in the comics. I'm assuming.
I don't know how that's going to be in the movie, but that's the story, that I know.
Yeah, the trailer looks good.
I like it.
The first trailer I wasn't too psyched about. The second one really kind of got my attention.
Well, that first one was kind of weird because it was made for Comic-Con and it was super early, and they did not intend to release that until it just leaked everywhere like crazy. They put it out in HD so it didn't look like garbage for everyone to see.
Steve, you said there was one super cringy moment for you in the trailer. What was that?
It was at the end of the trailer. When Harley Quinn breaks into the display as they're walking down the street and steals something.
Mm-hmm.
And then the guy, I can't remember who's the guy that's actually like the captain of them.
Rick Flag.
Yeah.
It'd be Rick Flag.
He turns around and he says and makes some comment about what's wrong with you people or whatever. And she makes the comment, "We're the bad guys." Or I remember the exact word.
We're bad guys.
And it was just so, it seems so forced and corny.
But she is. I think she's. But Harley Quinn's like really cheesy. Like she says goofy stuff sometimes.
I don't.
I think.
I mean, she's like, she balances between absolute adorable and then absolute insanity. So
yeah, but that doesn't mean cheese.
Well, yeah.
That line, I mean, that line was okay. Like, it didn't, like, I think some of the other,
it didn't define her, but it didn't ruin her either.
Like, no, but like everything else, she seems to be like a major piece of the movie. Mm-hmm. Like, because they're really like lauding her a lot, like in the trailers. But
well, she's a super popular character.
Yeah,
sure. They seem to have gotten someone that will do the part well for what they're going for. Even though I know a lot of people aren't too hyped about like the excessive tattoos between her and the Joker.
Mm.
But hey, if that's the style they're going for, it kind of works with the way they're doing the new Batman.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. I mean, that line to me kind of wasn't the best part of the trailer. So hopefully it's just kind of the context didn't show it well. I mean, it didn't jump out to me like that, but yeah, it wasn't like I was like, oh yeah, like there were other parts of that trailer that I thought set a really good tone that I hope they can nail.
I could see where it would be cringy, but it didn't bother me personally.
My one hope is that Will Smith is in it as Deadshot.
Mm-hmm.
I really hope they just don't try to make him a hero, even though
he sees the error of his ways, and now he's all in on this good guy.
I think you're going to be disappointed.
I know, but I just want him to play a piece of shit.
I think once, in one of the trailers, they already really showed him with his daughter, and I think they're really going to push. He's just trying to do right by her, and he's got caught up in some bad stuff. I too want to see. Because kind of Deadshot is kind of like Deathstroke, to where they sometimes portray him as someone with honor, and other times portray him as a real piece of shit. And I kind of like more of the piece of shit version.
Yeah, and like Green Arrow, I mean, he basically has that arc story where he goes from shit to hero, but not give anything away. Spoiler alert! And so he shoots someone.
I don't know if you know how spoiler alerts work.
Enough. I can do a louder one.
No, the volume.
So Snape killed Dumbledore.
Yeah.
No,
then do the buzzer.
Spoiler alert.
Yes.
Wait, wasn't the cloud.
No, Brent, you've got this.
A spoiler alert after, so people know.
Let them know what you said.
Trying to find the right.
No, he's got this.
Spoiler alert.
There you go.
That's how you do it.
Yep. No, you got it right now.
Aha! The one thing I'm still mad, and I've said it a billion times, and I'm gonna say it again, still very, very, very disappointed in DC that they're using different actors in the movies than they are in the TV shows. Like The Flash, a whole different actor, which is, I think it's bad. It sends, what they're saying in interviews is like, oh, it's a great way to continue our story. It's like, but you're not. You're using entirely different actors. So I don't like that.
Yeah. No, it's a bummer. They had a great way to kind of catch up with how Marvel has established everything by taking
that continuity.
Yeah, like they would have had a world established going into this first, you know, joint cinematic universe movie. It sucks, but
yeah,
whatever. I'm hopeful that they do it right. Starting with this movie, which is like 2 months away. It's not that far away now.
Pretty close.
And then Suicide Squad is this August, so we will see.
Gonna be good times. Getting into some hardware. Steve.
Hi.
I heard you got a television set.
I did.
Is it in color or is it in black and white?
I spent the extra money and I got the color.
That's a color. Did you get stereo sound?
Yeah.
Yeah. Did you get?
Did it come in a sweet cabinet for you to like put stuff on top of it?
Is it like one that sits on the ground and has a big wooden like furniture aspect to it? No.
I want to get in on this. Is it a smart TV? Does it have a VCR?
Oh, built in. Built into it.
Shannon.
Okay.
That was my first TV. It was actually a TV VCR combo.
Yeah.
So off.
Yeah.
Our,
a lot of money inch, back then.
13-inch TV?
It was 19.
Oh, my first one in my bedroom that I got when I was a kid was a 13-inch.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I thought it was so cool. Played my Genesis on it, and I'm like thinking now, remember. Like playing on that.
I can't remember if mine was a 17 or a 19. I thought it was a 19 with a built-in VCR. Hooked up my SNES to it.
Mm. So anyways, is this one like, you know, similar to that?
A little bit. anyways, I think did we talk about it last week that I had ordered one?
Nope.
Yes, we did.
I know we had talked about it.
I didn't talk about it.
It was on the show. I ordered a 4K TV. It came in Monday. Got it all hooked up.
Yeah, but I mean, but like enough about how much it costs. Like what?
Hero's song is gonna look incredible on that thing.
Fuck every yeah, pixel. Man. Imagine those sprites.
Ugh, man. Popping. Tons of. But yeah, got a new TV.
Cool.
The other one was breaking. Fortunately.
Yeah, we talked about that, but.
Huh?
Right.
Did you watch any 4K content on it?
I have watched a little bit of 4K content. Started watching the Marco Polo series.
Yeah, that's a good looking show.
Yeah.
It is a really good looking show in 4K. It is sharp, crisp.
Yeah, I would have bet. That, I mean, that's a well-shot show. I think that show is okay. Like, otherwise, like,
we kind of lost interest halfway through.
The end of the season was kind of eh, but it's coming back for another season.
I like the beginning of the season.
And I started watching. I didn't get too far into, I guess, similarly to Marco Polo, I didn't get very far into that either. But Man in High Castle.
Yeah, that's a great show. That's so a far, great looking yeah. show too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There was a part like right in the beginning though, where the guy is like walking through the city, and it may have just been the way the show is shot, or maybe I don't know if it's because of the 4K or if you can see it anyways, but the whole thing looked weird. Like that,
it kind of has a weird color palette to it anyway.
Okay, maybe that's what I was saying. Just the way the city was lit, and he just really seemed like he was.
Was this
on
San Francisco?
A green screen.
Was this the San Francisco part?
No, he was on the guy on the East Coast, the kid.
Oh, okay.
It was like he was on his way to. It was right in the beginning. He was on his way to try to. I think he was leaving the theater, like right off at the beginning of the show.
Okay.
And when he walked outside and he was walking across the street or whatever, it just like was screaming that it was shot on a green screen.
Hmm. Okay. Hmm. Interesting.
So that might be the bad part about 4K. Maybe that'll make things
you might
more
see too
evident.
Much.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think that's going to be a problem. But I will say regular TV doesn't really look any different. And my wife constantly complains about how it doesn't look any different. So why do we spend the money on this TV if it doesn't look any different?
I heard she was blind.
She's blind. She needs her eyes checked. Because I think it does look a smidge better, but she'll never
see
it.
But are you hopeful? Are you just super hopeful that it looks better and so it really doesn't? But you're just
Actually, I because the TV was not completely broken... The last TV, and because we haven't gotten rid of it yet.
You did a side-by-side comparison.
Top and bottom, actually, because I set the one TV right in front of the new one, and I had composite cable running from the old TV into the...
Fuck, I like this.
Playing the same thing
getting
at the same time.
Getting down to business.
Did
yeah.
you show her? Did you show her she was wrong? And how did that go over?
I had her come out to the other room and sat
she
her down in front of the TV.
Slapped me twice.
I said, "Look,
yeah, you did.
Oh my god, how are you not divorced?"
So how's the couch?
I'm sure she saw the error of her ways.
You're so dumb.
What was funny about it?
You need some Advil for the back problems sleeping on the couch.
Here's what was funny about it is that when she first saw it, she's looking at them both, and she points at the new TV and says, "Well, that one actually looks better."
Okay.
I was like, "Yeah." And then I pulled up the guide, and she goes, "No, but the words still look weird." I'm like, fuck. So she still won't let me live. Just the fucking guide. The guide is what's bothering her.
It's because
I think she's asleep. So
is that because that's created for 1080p?
I think it's because of the way that it's being blown up on the 4K. It's doing. I don't really see it, and that's why I think that she needs to get her eyes checked. Because she's seeing like there's something weird with the words that are on the guide that it looks a little off.
Man,
so I don't know.
How does
I like it?
Do video games look? I mean, they're the same or?
Yeah, since we are a video game podcast, I will say I played a little bit of Destiny, and I played a little bit of Rocket League with my son. That's the one thing that I've seen so far that's been the big difference. Like, well, I can't say that because movies too. I watched a little bit of Mad Max Fury Road, and I watched all of Grand Budapest Hotel actually for the last time.
Oh,
and holy shit!
Movie.
It looked so sharp.
Movie.
I would love to see that. Yeah,
and it's a it's a pretty movie. Anyways, I haven't seen it otherwise from this TV, but God damn, it was pretty. I actually like the next day. I wanted to just go watch it again.
Yeah, you should play Journey on your PS4.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Yeah. Because you had it on PS3, right?
I did.
Yeah, so you get to download for free on PS4.
Yeah, I should do that. I will say, Destiny, I it might just be because we bought a quote-unquote nicer TV than what we had, but like the color contrast, the black levels and everything are really, really helping out. It's just everything is really crisp. Like the new arena in Rocket League, the sand that's on there, like you can kind of see the detail a little bit better. Mm. But I mean, everything, the frame rate is not changed at all. Nothing's really going to get improved too much by the TV, but I think it just is helping out with how much of the detail you're actually seeing. There's, because like, I think back to like Dark Souls and like when you saw Dark Souls go from console to PC and you could see, like when you up-resed all that stuff to PC graphics, you could see there was a lot of detail that they put into the game that you weren't necessarily seeing. And I think that's the one thing you might get a little bit out of with 4K. But again, I've only played like two games, so I don't, this isn't gospel by any means.
Yeah, you should shut up.
I probably should.
Whoa.
Probably shut up on the pot.
There's some pixels for you.
But yeah, the Journey thing's actually a good idea. I should play that again.
Yeah.
It's a short game, too.
Yeah.
Pick up today
on
my way home.
One of the best games ever made, I will say.
Yeah.
I picked up a game on my way home.
Yeah, what game?
Mario Maker.
Oh, well, okay, yeah.
I hear good things.
Gotta have that game.
Excited to play that this weekend with the kids.
It's gonna look great in 4K.
I don't think that's gonna make it.
That's happen. Like, that's why you get it. That's why you get a 4K television.
That's what we do it for.
Mm.
But yeah, that's my hardware update.
Awesome.
Cool.
Nice.
I have an announcement. I'm within 40,000 coins of getting my crossbow. I just have to keep my iPad on until I do one more attack.
How long is that?
Let's see. Like 20 minutes.
Oh, you gonna make it?
Yeah.
There.
Just keep tapping it. Tapping it. Because if I let this go 1 second into sleep mode, I'm going to get attacked, and it's going to be 300,000 coins taken away. So
start all over again.
No! Much work. So close. But anyway, that's all I got.
That's all I got.
That's all I got.
Are we calling it?
I think so.
I can get to bed.
Ladies and gentlemen, thanks for joining us for this episode of Multiplay. Or oh my gosh, I've been listening to I know,
yes, for me,
I've been listening to so many of those, loading them up on YouTube.
Yeah, we've jumped the shark.
That's
the moment right there. If we can all just kind of say that's when we went downhill, when you just said that.
All right, well, you close it out, you bitch.
Hey, Slurms.
Get the fuck out of here.
Said like a pro.
Fuck it. Put shit to bed. Let's log off.
Show is in the can. Thanks for listening to the MMO Show. Questions, comments, feedback, errors, etc. can be sent to email.themmoshow@gmail.com. We invite you to write a review on iTunes, follow us on Facebook and Twitter, and various other social media at The MMO Show, and visit our website at themmoshow.com. I don't know if I'm into this anymore.
No, let's just cancel it.
Yeah.
This podcast is part of the Game and Entertainment Network. Visit TGENetwork.net to find the latest episodes from all our shows.
You have fireworks in the background.
Because it's a firework. Let them go up and then.
You don't know the words.
To the sky.
He doesn't know the words.
No, that's them.
That's them? All right.
That's the words.
Do you ever feel like a plastic bag?
I don't.
Drifting on the wind.
You looked up the lyrics.
No, I was about to look up the chords.
You can't fool me.
I say I'm about to look it up, but I believe I have that. Oh, no. Where are my bookmarks? My bookmarks are gone. Travesty.
Let's see.
Chords. Firework Chords by Katy Perry.
Perrier.
She is so awesome. She's up there with Kesha.
Let's edit the scene.
Is that slang for something?
That and Carly Simon.
Steve Cam.
Think anybody's ever put Kesha and Carly Simon in the same.
Just let them go. Just let them talk.
I like it.
So do you ever feel
never
like a plastic bag? I don't really know how this goes. I'm just looking at it.
He's winging it, ladies and gentlemen. We're not live yet, though.
Oh, thank God. Do you ever feel...
See, now it's like, whoa.
Feel so paper thin, like a house of cards, one blow from caving in. You just gotta ignite Jason's a firework.
Aww.
Come on, come on. What's your word?
Jason didn't sing it.
That got really good once my name was said.
Once this was about me.
I love when things are all about me.
Me. And scene.
And the crowd goes wild.
The crowd goes wild. You did really good.
I used to know the words, and then I haven't sung in a while forever.
That's what happened. You turned yours on after I set Brent's up. That's what happened. I can fix it. Sounds pretty cool.
I tried that trick where you get a paper towel and wet it and put it around your beer and put it in the freezer.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Works pretty good.
Save either that for the show.
But I didn't, I've got a few more. But I didn't do like a control. I needed a control where I put one in that's warm that I didn't wrap. Now I don't know if it works or not.
True.
Could just because it's a freezer. Freezers make shit cold.
They do.
They do. They really do. Oh, I see. Why are you on there twice? I have a weird... Oh, is that Slurms Cam, maybe?
Yeah, that's weird.
Oh, fuck. Yeah, it's Steve's cam. We'll just...
Yeah, it is. It is.
What I do?
Nothing. I have to get the order right or we overlap into the monitors. It looks weird, but we're ready. So...